Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome. You are at the Pennsylvania Admissions Counseling Association College Fair. We're at a virtual college fair powered by ScriveScan. Welcome. My name is Sabel Rasim. I'll be your facilitator for this evening's session. I'm super excited to get started. We have a lot of great institutions here this evening to tell you a little bit about themselves. And I say a little bit because this is like an appetizer, right? So you get to know a little bit about each institution, but you do have a lot more digging to do to really be able to enjoy each and every bit of information they give you today, because they're going to be giving you just a little bit. So make sure that you have your little notepad, or maybe have your phone next to you. Make sure you're taking some notes so that you can follow up. We will be using different features of Zoom, which I'll just mention in just a second, to be able to either answer your questions or be able to give you contact info and more information on these presenters so that you can follow up with them afterwards. So without further ado, just some housekeeping items here. If you would like to ask questions, please type those questions in the Q&A button that's in your Zoom toolbar. So when you click on that Q&A button, you'll type in those questions to the presenters at any time. Now I stress at any time. Please do not wait until the last minute to ask those questions. This is only about a 45-minute virtual college fair, and we do not have a live Q&A happening at the end. Once again, we do not have a live Q&A happening at the end. So please ask those questions in that Q&A in your Zoom toolbar at any time. Also, please, if you could do us a favor, please put the institution's name within your question, just so we all know who the question goes to and our presenters can answer those questions at any point in time for you. Also, you're muted and your video is turned off, so the panelists cannot see or hear you. So once again, using that Q&A button in your Zoom toolbar is super important to be able to get those questions answered. Fun fact, the chat will have some notifications potentially pop up as well. Our panelists and presenters will be putting their contact information or links that they want you to check out within the chat. So don't forget to check out the chat as well. Also, sign up for more sessions. This is one out of many, many college presentations that are offered. So please go ahead and sign up for that next time slot. And last but certainly not least, this is being recorded. Now, cool fact here is that if maybe mom missed out on tonight, maybe a friend of yours wants to check out these schools with you, or maybe you just want to relive the fun, all these sessions are going to be recorded and will be available at strivescan.com/Pennsylvania. So please feel free to check that out within the next few business days. All right, now without further ado, I'd love to get started. First up, we have Susquehanna University.
Okay, hi guys. I'm just gonna take the time and share my screen for you. All right, so my name is Sarah. I'm Assistant Director of Admission at Susquehanna. I also graduated from Susquehanna in 2014, so I'm excited to tell you a little bit about my previous home. So Susquehanna, we're a small private liberal arts college. We're located in Selins Grove, Pennsylvania, which is about 45 minutes north of Harrisburg, so central PA. As a liberal arts college, you'll be taking classes both inside and outside of your major. So you'll be taking a mixture of major courses, central curriculum classes, as well as elective courses at Susquehanna. Your average class size here will be about 18 students in a classroom, making your student to faculty ratio about 13 to 1. We don't have any graduate students on our campus, so we're an undergraduate only school, which I think is really nice because you won't have to wait behind graduate students to use any of our lab facilities or to wait for your faculty members' time. All of your faculty members will also be full-time faculty and not graduate teaching assistants or anything like that. Just a few items. So this is an example of one of our lab classes here at Susquehanna. We really try to get our students out of the classroom and getting all of these types of hands-on experiences. So Susquehanna, we're about a half a mile from the Susquehanna River. So we try to use that in all of our lab classes as much as we can. So this is just an example of some of our students taking a lab class down by the Susquehanna. One really unique aspect of our curriculum is our Global Opportunities Program. So this is actually built into our curriculum where 100% of our students will study away from campus at some point before they graduate. So there's a few different ways that you can do this. You can either do a go long program, a go short program, or a go your own way program. Go long is a full semester trip where you're taking a full course load at another international university, and then all those courses will transfer back to Susquehanna. A go short program is over a shorter length of time over one of our summer or winter breaks, and it's more of a group-led trip. And then a go your way program is essentially a design your own trip where you can go anywhere that you'd like to. Right now we have over 125 different programs on every continent except for Antarctica. So there really is a lot that you can choose from. We do bookend your trip with a pre-preparation and then a post-reflection course. So we don't just send you to like Morocco or Barcelona or wherever it is that you choose to go without any sort of preparation. And then when you return from your trip, you'll take a course that teaches you how to market your experience in like a job or internship interview and how to write about it in your resume or cover letter in a way that an employer will find really meaningful. We also offer over 150 different active clubs and organizations on campus that you can get involved in, everything from service opportunities to club sports, Greek life on campus. So lots of different things like that you can be involved in. About 25% of our student body is made up of student athletes. We're a Division III school where most of our students, our sports teams play in the Landmark Conference. Our football team is the exception to that. They play in the Centennial Conference. What I like about being a Division III institution is that we are competitive, but academics still come first on campus. So you'll never get that kind of conflicting feeling where you need to choose between going to sports practice or going to class. It's still an academics comes first sort of environment. Okay, so right now, 96% of our alumni are working full-time or are in graduate school within 6 months of graduation. This is a statistic we're really proud of. You know, partially we owe that to some really great resources we have for students on campus. One is the Center for Academic Achievement, which is essentially our tutoring hub for on campus, where you can go in there and get a tutor for really any class that you're taking, not necessarily just a general subject area, but an exact, you know, class that you're taking. We also, right across the hall from the Center for Academic Achievement, have a Career Development Center where you can go and be connected with our alumni network who can help you out with getting jobs and internships in your field. Okay, so I want to run through the application requirements with you. We're on both the Common Application and our own Susquehanna Success application. It doesn't matter to us which you use, just whatever's easiest for you. We also require your official high school transcript, your SAT or ACT scores. We're also test score optional, at least one letter of recommendation from a counselor or a teacher, your personal essay, and then just by applying to Susquehanna, you're automatically considered for merit scholarship awards, right now up to $38,000 a year. And then by October 1st or on October 1st, you can apply for additional need-based financial aid. Okay, so we hope to see you on campus soon, and I'll leave my contact information in the chat if you guys have any additional questions.
Perfect. Thank you so much. If you have any questions for Susquehanna University, go ahead and please put it in that Q&A. Next up, we have Lawrence Technological University.
All right. Thank you so much for having me. Let me just share my screen real quick and get this thing started. My name is Spencer Mattinson. I'm an admissions advisor here at Lawrence Tech. And as we joked about earlier, my presentation doesn't want to work. So give me 1 second to do that. I will work with students all in Pennsylvania. And if you have any questions or want to apply, you can contact me. My contact information is in the last slide of this presentation here. So let's get this thing going. That is Lawrence Tech right there. We are located in Southfield, Michigan. That's about 25 minutes north of Detroit. And we're in a really nice location because we are right by Novi, Royal Oak, and Auburn Hills, and those don't really mean anything to students that are out of state. But what's really cool about that when you look those areas up is that they're really large in industry. We have connections with so many different automotive companies and engineering companies and businesses, everything from Rocket Mortgage to Chrysler to Ford to Bosch. You know, we're all over the place. So students really get a chance to have hands-on work while they're at Lawrence Tech. As you kind of see some of our statistics around the sides there, and we are a small private school, only about 3,000 students on our campus, and we really pride ourselves on this idea of theory and practice. Now, we have four different colleges within our university, engineering, arts and sciences, business, and architecture and design. We are the number one architecture school in Michigan. Over half of Michigan architects are from Lawrence Tech, and then we are one of the number one engineering schools in the country. If you see a double asterisk on the screen, that's a program where you can get a bachelor's and a master's degree in 5 years. So we've done that for architectural engineering, computer science. So you really have a chance to be able to advance in your career really early on. And then we also have pre-professional programs on the bottom there as well. So you would major just in a College of Arts and Sciences program, and then you could go into doing medical school or dental school or whatever you need to do. It is direct entry into your program. So you're gonna start classes in your major freshman year. Average class size is about 17 students. Our average lab size is smaller than that. We really wanna make sure that you're gonna have a chance to stand out in your field and also in your classroom as well. We wanna make sure that you know your professors and they will be able to know you. We're founded on this idea of theory and practice about 100 years ago today. The Lawrence brothers, they built Lawrence Tech right next to Henry Ford's first automotive plant. So the workers could go to school at night and they could get that work experience during the day. And we've really created our own academic program through that model. So a lot of labs, hands-on components, you can kind of see everything from our nursing labs on the top right to our chemistry labs on the top left, our SAE garage, our structural testing center on the bottom right, where you actually can test load-bearing materials like concrete. We actually have designed a bridge in Southfield, one with carbon fiber, one with concrete, to be able to see which one will last longer over a 10-year period. Our students did that. It's a really cool opportunity. So all of our classes can be very lab-focused and have that component where you gain that hands-on experience. And that's where our location really bodes well, as I said earlier. Lots of internship experience. About 3/4 of our students have an internship or co-op while they're at Lawrence Tech. We do have athletics as well. If you are interested in kind of getting a, you know, athletic kind of sport feel to your collegiate time, we also have over 60 clubs and organizations, everything from Greek life, fraternities, sororities, organizations that are focused on your major, things like Oreo Eating Club and Dungeons and Dragons. So we have like fun ones as well. It's super easy to start a club if you want to as well. We are a part of the NAIA. And we're part of the ACHA for hockey. There are scholarships available, but you need to go onto that athletics website and fill out a recruitment form if you want to be a part of that. We have residence halls on campus. We just built a brand new one in 2018 for our freshman residents. And everything is free from parking to your utilities to, you know, laundry areas and things like that. Everything is taken care of when you're there. One of the big questions we always get, you know, is what kind of scholarships are available? How much does it cost? It's all going to be based upon the program that you go into. We're a private school, so there are no out-of-state fees. You get reviewed for a merit-based scholarship when you apply. And then for being an out-of-state student, you're going to get our Blue Devil Scholars Award. And that's going to be additional $5,000 on top of any merit scholarship you get. So our average merit scholarship is about $12,000 a year. And then you can add that on top. And then you just kind of see over there, our average financial aid package is about $25,000. So it really comes into play there to make it affordable for our students. And then what's cool is that we are really focused for the after the college time ends, kind of that factor. So 92% of our students have jobs in their field at time of graduation. So we really want to make sure that you're prepared for your postgraduate success, you know, really early on in your collegiate career, so that right when you step on that stage to get that diploma, you can start your job as soon as possible. And that's really attributed to our career services program. We have job fairs on campus. We have Handshake. It's an online database that students can connect with companies really early on. And then again, that internship connection is really key. And then we are one of the highest schools in the country for our graduates with boosting earning potentials. So the whole point of that is to make sure that the money that you get as you go along, once you've graduated, increases as you go along with your actual career, post-collegiate career. And then last but not least, here's my contact information. That's the picture they chose for me. So, you know, don't judge too hard, but email, my phone number for my office, and then the text number as well. Feel free to utilize any of those if you want to text in instead of having to send an email or call, because not all of us like talking on the phone. I understand. You can text right there. We are doing visits on campus. Just let me know. We can sign you up for one of those. And if you want to actually do a presentation that speaks with any of our actual faculty members, we offer that as well. So you can talk with architecture, our College of Business, really get to see what they do and check those things out. But that's all for me. Thank you guys for listening. And I'm gonna pop my contact information again inside the chat box. So thanks, guys.
Awesome, thank you so much. If you have any questions for Lawrence Technological University, please put it in the Q&A. Next up, we have Fairleigh Dickinson University.
All right, just give me 1 second. Let me get it all set up. Okay, hi everyone. My name is Megan Troy. I'm an undergraduate admissions counselor for Fairleigh Dickinson University. We are located in New Jersey. We have two campuses, our Florham campus located in Madison, New Jersey, about 20 miles from New York City, and then our Metropolitan campus located in Teaneck, New Jersey, about 6 miles from New York City. We have over 100 different options in majors and concentrations. Our students have the opportunity to double major, major and minor, however they would like to facilitate their academic goals. They could just work with our academic departments to make that happen. We are a medium-sized institution for the state of New Jersey, but since we have two campuses, we kind of run like a small institution. Our students to faculty ratio is about 12 students to every one faculty member, and average class sizes are about 20 to 25 per class. And they get significantly smaller as you matriculate through your academic program. Currently, we have over 146 active student organizations across our two campuses, and that can include social organizations, Greek life, academic organizations, pre-professional clubs, sports clubs, just about anything you can think of. And if it doesn't exist, of course, our student government allows for students to start new organizations all the time. We have something called our Combined Degree Advantage Program, where we have 43 different academic programs that allow for students to not only study and earn a bachelor's degree, but in one extra academic year, they can earn their master's degree. And that is definitely a benefit because you can save a year of time for most academic programs, and also you can save yourself a year of money on your graduate studies. A little bit about our two campuses. We do have two different athletic divisions. We have Division I athletics on our Metropolitan campus in Teaneck, Division III on our campus, our Florham campus in Madison. If students want to play a sport, they also have to attend the campus that they are playing for. Unfortunately, you can't enroll on one campus and play a sport on the other. Like I mentioned, we are considered a medium-sized institution, but how our campuses are, they're still fairly small, about 3,000 undergraduates on the Metro campus, about 2,600 on the Florham campus. We have residence life available on both campuses, so as students coming from Pennsylvania, you're more than likely going to want to live on campus, so that is available to you. With our Metropolitan campus, while all of our academics are for the most part based on both campuses, we do have some programs that are only going to be on specific campuses. For our Metro campus, that's going to be our engineering and engineering technologies programs, criminal justice, and marine biology. And then our Florham campus, it has a little bit of history to the property itself. Used to belong to the Vanderbilt Trombley family, if you remember them from American history. But this campus caters a lot to our students in the creative arts. So students looking for theater, creative writing, film, animation, and our criminology programs and communication, you would have to attend our Florham campus. All other academic programs, for the most part, are going to be split into our 9 colleges and schools and available on both of our campuses. So if you have any specific questions about where your program might be located, of course, I'll put my contact information in the chat. Feel free to reach out to me at a later time. It's very important for students to get experiences not just inside the classroom, but outside of it as well. So internships and mentoring and networking opportunities are available at FDU through your academic departments. There are going to be liaisons that help you with internship and, of course, job placement for after graduation. You can also receive that help in our career development office. Frequently, we will have speakers come to our campus, whether it's from the UN Pathways program or if it's academic related and it comes directly from your department. Study abroad is also a really big deal for FDU. We do have two campuses of our own that are located in England and in Canada. Students can study abroad on those two campuses for the exact same cost that they are paying to be on our New Jersey campuses. So that is a definite benefit. If those two places don't kind of get you going, then we have other opportunities for study abroad, of course, all around the world. So you would work with your department and our study abroad office to make that happen. I mentioned we are close to New York City, and because of that, we do a lot of activities in the city, or students have internships there. Getting to and from our campuses to New York is very easy. The city of Teaneck has a New Jersey Transit bus that takes students right into the heart of Manhattan. And then from our Florham campus, there is a train station that's less than a mile from campus that can get students to New York City as well. So the most important part, of course, is how do I apply to FDU? We are a part of the Common App, but we also have our own application housed on our website. So you are more than welcome to fill out either of those. If it's easier to just do Common App, we definitely will take it. Our applications usually open up mid-August, at the latest, the first week of September. Once you've submitted your application, you only need to submit your official high school transcript. We are SAT optional for a majority of our academic programs. We, at the moment, only have one program that still requires test scores, and any student applying for those programs, we will let them know what their options are if they do not have test scores available. We have a priority deadline of December 1st, and what that basically means is our application fee is going to be waived up until that date, and we also give additional grant opportunities for students that apply by then. You are all considered for scholarships once you apply to FDU. Our merit-based scholarships currently go up to $24,000 for the academic school year. Of course, once a student has been admitted to the university, if they have a FAFSA on file, we will process a financial aid package for them. And those usually start going out mid-December, early January. We are having tours on our campus, both virtually and in person. So if you have any interest in visiting us, please do so. If you want more information about the university, you can download our brochure. And lastly, here's my contact information. I'll put that in the chat as well. So thank you for joining us today. I hope I was able to give you enough information about FDU.
Awesome, thank you so much. If you have any questions for Fairleigh Dickinson University, please put it in the Q&A. Next up, we have RIT or Rochester Institute of Technology.
All right, great. Let me just go ahead and share my screen just a moment. Oh, my mistake. Okay, thank you so much everyone for joining us today. My name is Dan Hassis and I'm one of the admissions counselors from the Rochester Institute of Technology, or better known as RIT. So if you're not familiar with RIT, we are a private university located in Rochester, New York. So to kind of put it in context from a Pennsylvania standpoint, we are about 4 hours from Pittsburgh and about 6 hours from Philadelphia in upstate Western New York. As you can see, we're one of the larger private universities in the country, given our overall enrollments. So we have about a medium to larger school experience for our students based on this enrollment number. However, we still balance it out with a smaller school experience within the classroom. As you can see, we have about a 13-1 student to faculty ratio and average class size about 22. So it's a nice little balance between a larger school experience outside of the classroom for our students, but a much smaller school experience within the classroom. Within the classroom, we have 9 different colleges that make up our university, and we offer more than 90 different degree programs at the undergraduate or bachelor levels. So there's a wide array of academic areas that students can choose to pursue a major within or their degree within. So you can choose anything in regards to engineering, to computing, to engineering technology, to multiple different sciences. We also, along with that though, we have a full College of Art and Design where we have degree programs within art, design, film and animation, photography. And in addition to that, we even have a full College of Business and full College of Liberal Arts. So the benefit of having such a wide array of these different degree programs and academic areas is students, while they major in one program, will have the option to take electives in other areas or potentially pursue minors in other areas as well. No matter what, every one of our degree programs has a really strong focus on experiential learning. So what that really means is more learning by doing or finding some form of real world application within the degree program. So it's actually a couple different aspects of this focus is our focus within undergraduate research, internship, and also our co-op program. RIT is one of only 4 schools that's known as a co-op university. So what a co-op is, it's full-time paid professional experience that you complete while you're still enrolled as a student at RIT. So it's a time where you're taking, time away from classes and working within a field or industry or at a company that is specific for your particular major or academic area. So as you can see from this slide, we're one of only 9 nationally recognized universities that 4 are options available within co-op, internship, and undergraduate research as well. This kind of highlights a little bit more of just what co-op is for our students. Like you see, over 90% of our degree programs have a co-op option or requirement built within the degree programs. But we've been doing co-op for over 100 years at RIT, and it's really a very beneficial aspect for our students, specifically for our overall outcome rate as well, making that connection for with our students with industry as well. So as you can imagine, our overall outcome rate continues to remain relatively high from a year-to-year standpoint. We have about a 94% overall outcome rate of our graduates. You can see some of the companies that our students are being hired by for both co-op and also full-time placement as well. And then if you're interested in learning more specific information based on academic area or degrees from a job outlook standpoint, highly recommend visiting the joboutlook.rit.edu website. In addition to that, going back to that student life experience, we do have a very vibrant campus and a very involved student body. So I remember from the very first slide, we have about 14,000 undergraduate students, a little less than that, enrolled at RIT, and they have a wide range of interests. So there are multiple different clubs and organizations that we have that our students get involved in, and a wide array of different events that take place every year. So if you're interested in something like athletics or performing arts or volunteer work or something that's a little bit more STEM-based or something that's a little bit more leadership-focused, there's a ton that you can get involved in from a student life standpoint, and it's continuously very active as well. Just from a mission standpoint, so we are on the Common App. We have our own RIT application as well. So it doesn't matter to us which way you apply in regards to applying to RIT. The application does, I believe, typically open up around mid-August, like most of the other universities as well. And it's a pretty seamless process. We do require your application, or we do require a completed application, the application payments, your official high school transcript. We are test optional for SAT and ACT scores. So you can choose when submitting the application if you'd like your SAT or ACT score included in your admissions review or not. And then we also require just your essay and at least one letter of recommendation as part of the review process as well. But if you do have any additional questions beyond today, feel free to reach out to myself directly and I'm happy to help. You can see my email is up there. And there are also additional opportunities for you to visit campus as well. So we do have campus tours that are going on daily. We also have some student-led virtual options or just virtual ways you can connect with our office if you have any specific questions as well, and we are happy to help. All right, thank you.
Awesome, thank you so much. If you have any questions for RIT, go ahead and please put it in that Q&A. Next up, we have F&M College or Franklin and Marshall.
Thank you so much. My name is Shelby Jones, and it's great to be with you all tonight. I am one of the assistant directors of admission here at F&M, and I will be talking about Franklin and Marshall here for the next 6 minutes. For those of you who don't know where F&M is, we are located in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, which is just about an hour and 15 minutes from Philadelphia, 40 minutes from our state capital, Harrisburg, about 3 hours from New York, and about 2 hours from DC. Franklin and Marshall College is a small liberal arts college. We have about 2,400 students on campus, and we are a really diverse campus. We value diversity in every sense of the word. So we have students coming from all over the world with different backgrounds, different beliefs, coming together and creating a really robust campus community. Instead of just dormitories, we have college houses on campus, which is your instant form of community. As soon as you step foot on campus, you will live, grow, learn, and succeed in your college houses. We have over 60 areas of study for you to choose from and for you to structure in different ways that will serve you best. For as small as our campus population is, we really do have a lot going on with over 100 student-run organizations and clubs. Athletically, we are a D3 school with the exception of men's wrestling and squash. And if you are interested in playing sports at F&M, I can drop a link in the chat later on with more information about that. And with all that said, we are one F and Emily, and it is very cheesy, but it actually is true. We really do want students to feel comfortable and at home on campus. And there's a lot of structural ways that we make sure that this occurs for every student, no matter what your background is. Academically, I think is what we do best. We really value small class sizes and an interdisciplinary curriculum where you're going to be forced to push the academic boundaries. We have an average class size of 17 students and a 9-to-1 student to faculty ratio. So you're going to have a lot of exposure to your professors and your peers both in and out of the classroom. About 80% of our classes are discussion-based, so this might be a different experience than you may have in high school, but we really do believe that is the best way for our students to learn because it kind of forces you to inherently connect with it, the material that you're learning. Research is really big on campus, and that extends so far beyond the microscope. As you may assume, you can do research in any area of study, and our professors are really willing to work with students. So it's a really great way to have hands-on experience outside of the classroom. Here is a picture inside one of our college houses. So we have community infused into our college houses. Each college house has its own great room, fireplace room, seminar room, where you'll most likely take one of your first year classes, as well as a student-run government system whose role is to plan events for your college house. So there's a lot going on in our residential campus community, and this is just one of the five living areas that you could encounter. Outside of the classroom and outside of the college houses, we really want you to be really engaged in your community. So one of the ways you can do that is by joining in lots of clubs or engaging outside of campus with Lancaster PA. We have partnerships with over 80 local institutions and organizations. So whether that would be internship related or volunteer work, we want you to get off campus and interact with our surrounding community. If you're interested in studying abroad, we have a lot of options for you, over 220 to be specific. So if you want to go to a specific place in the world or have a specifically structured program, our study abroad office will do all the legwork in finding the programs that work for you and helping you with the administrative tasks of getting to the country of your desire. So definitely study abroad is a great option for students. Keep that in the back burner as you continue to think about your college search. And then for our internship and postgraduate opportunities, we have our Office of Student and Postgraduate Development, which is called OSPGOD. And this will help you with everything related to life after FNM. Their tagline is they don't just prepare students for a successful career, they prepare students for a successful life. So it's a really holistic approach to life after FNM, and they make sure that you're prepared no matter whether you're going into a graduate opportunity, a job opportunity, or whatever it is, they will be there and they will have advisors there to help you. Here is a picture of our brand new, as of 2017 now, I guess, athletic field where our football team, soccer, lacrosse, and other sports play their sports on. It is a beautiful new facility and a really nice upgrade from what we had back when I was a student. So I'm a little bit envious that I graduated in 2016 and didn't have a chance to experience this as a student. But this is a great place for you to come hang out with your friends and support your fellow diplomats. Fun fact about FNM, we are the only diplomats in the country. So when you say go Dips, everybody's gonna know who you're rooting for. Then getting here. So if all the stuff that I said sounded great, let's talk a little bit about financial aid in the application. So FNM is a need-based institution, which means for our financial aid, we will take into consideration your unique financial situation. So we'll look at your FAFSA, your CSS profile, your parent or guardian tax documents, and other financial information when we go to issue a financial aid package. Basically, what your institutionally determined need is will be your financial aid for all 4 years. If you have additional questions about financial aid, I can put that in the chat as well. But as for the admission process, we offer a holistic approach. We are test optional, we're interview optional, we're on the Common and Coalition app, and we don't have any additional requirements for applications, kind of the bare minimum application with a personal statement. I think that's where I will stop. Thank you so much for tuning in. And if you have additional questions, I will put my information in the chat.
All right, awesome. Thank you so much. If you have any questions for FNM, please put it in the Q&A. So it looks like we have some extra time. I would love if our panelists and presenters could join me via video. I'd love to see your faces again. I'll give you all a few seconds to do so. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. And I have a question for you all. So give me 1 second to share my screen here. All right, so we can see my screen. I have a question up on the screen here. It says, what advice would you give someone going through the college search process? And what better way to find out than from the experts? So we're just gonna go in presentation order with Susquehanna University going first. And we do have time, so feel free to let us know what advice you would give to people in the college search process. Susquehanna?
Yeah, that's a good question. I would My advice would be just to really own your college search. I think you're, if you haven't already, you're going to get a lot of advice from like teachers, coaches, family members, you know, things that they really want you to do or not do, but also remember what you really are looking for in a school and keep that in mind too when you're looking at colleges.
Awesome, thank you. Lawrence Technological University?
Yeah, I mean, I normally tell my students, you know, go where you want to go. You're going to be pulled in a lot of directions. My grandpa went here, my dad went here, mom went here, boyfriend, girlfriend, best friend went over here, but there's going to be a school that's right for you, whether it be, you know, the program that's there or you just feel like it's a right fit. So just make sure you take this time to find the school that's best for you. Even if you don't know anybody that went there or is going there, it's going to work out in the end. So just make sure that you make the decision that's best for you and you're going to end up, you know, in a great place at the end of it all.
Awesome. Thank you. Fairleigh Dickinson?
I think my best advice is to take all the opportunities you have to learn about other institutions besides the ones that you may be most familiar with. Just on this panel alone, I'm with two colleagues who represent schools that I had family members attend, and had they not gone there, I would have never known about them. So attending events like this makes you learn about schools that you probably wouldn't have heard of, and then it gives you an opportunity to see somewhere you might fit in that you didn't know about before.
Awesome. Thank you. RIT.
Yeah. So, I mean, I think going off of Spencer's point and a couple of points, I think Sarah made it as well. Along with what they had said, determine what's most important to you as part of your college search. Figure out, you know, do you want a larger school, smaller school? Do you want particular majors, minors available? Do you want to be able to double major? And kind of determining that is the only way you're going to be able to do that is kind of exploring the different opportunities that are available, like this one as well. So I guess making a list or figuring out what is most important to you for your college experience to kind of help may help you throughout this college search process as well.
Awesome. Thank you. Franklin and Marshall.
Yeah, I would say at this point in your college search, don't say no to anything. I think you might have these preconceived notions about the size of institution that you want, where you want to go, but I think that really does limit you if you go in already having these ideas. So say yes to everything, and then you can narrow it down more in the fall or later on in the summer.
Awesome. Thank you all. And it looks like we still have some time. So I do have another really important question, and this actually is my favorite question. What is your favorite event or tradition on campus? Now, Susquehanna University, if you need a quick second, I know each institution has a lot of events and traditions that you all can pick from. But Sarah, if you had one in mind, what would you pick?
Yeah, no, this is an easy one for me. I have a favorite. It's our annual Thanksgiving dinner. So this is when all of our students, they get dressed up a little bit nicer. It happens right before our Thanksgiving break when you would go home and have Thanksgiving dinner with your actual family. You go down to the dining hall, dress up a little bit nicer, and you're served a traditional Thanksgiving meal by your faculty and staff members. Our university president will, you know, carve a turkey on your table. And then at the end of the night, they put all the leftovers in little Ziploc baggies and send them home with our students. So you can have like a midnight snack. So that's my favorite tradition.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Lawrence Technological University.
Yeah, so for me, and we missed it last year, but this fall it's going to be, you know, back and it'll be great. But our first year Ignite, it's the first week of when campus starts up. And it's mostly used to introduce freshmen to Lawrence Tech and our campus and kind of what we do. But a lot of students just returning use it to just get back together, connect. There's usually like fun events, like there's a concert and there's outdoor yoga and there's a lot of just, you know, free food. And it's a great way to just, also there's free stuff to be given away, but it's just a great way for our students to kind of get back to campus, kind of see what's happening and meet people. And it just is a nice kind of fun time before you start classes up again. And so I really am glad that we're gonna be getting back to that in the fall.
Awesome. Any time to meet people and get free food is always a great time. All right, Fairleigh Dickinson.
I have to definitely agree with that. Free food is always my jam, was in college and is still as a staff member. So mine is very similar. Right before finals, we have a late night breakfast that our faculty and staff come, and breakfast is my favorite time of food day, or favorite food of the day, excuse me. But we serve breakfast and it's a time for our students to kind of just unwind from studying from finals. So they come to the cafeteria and we serve them pancakes and eggs and bacon and all the good breakfasty foods. So that's probably one of my favorite events that happens on our campuses.
Awesome. Awesome. Thank you so much. RIT.
Yeah. So not to go a different route, because I'm not saying I don't enjoy food, because I definitely do as well. At RIT, we're Division three for the majority of our sports. We're actually Division one in men's and women's ice hockey. We do not have football, which is usually a big sport at majority of universities. So hockey is kind of like our main sport. It's actually, this is the background is the hockey facility as well. So any hockey game we can always get out to as a staff. It's a great way to kind of bring together the RIT community. There's a huge student section that attends as well. So just kind of feel that overall support and emphasis on the RIT community based around just a game of, or just a game of Division One game of hockey is always fun to go to.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And I'm sure those games have great food as well. So you didn't break the tradition. It's okay. All right. F&M.
So I would say my tradition would be a bit later on in your experience at F&M, and it's during your entire senior year. There are specific senior events throughout the fall and spring semester, but the last event is a senior bonfire where the entire senior class comes together and celebrate the fact that they've completed their 4 years before graduation. It's just a really good time and a nice way to wrap up your 4 years on campus.
Awesome. Thank you all so, so much. I know I learned a lot, and I think our attendees definitely did as well. So thank you all so, so, so much for that. And my participants, my attendees, thank you so much for joining as well and listening in. Remember how I began this virtual college fair? This is just an appetizer. There's so much to learn about these institutions. So feel free, check out the chat, make sure you got the panelists and presenters contact information, any links they want you to check out so that you can learn a little bit more about them. Also, before you leave, after you close out the window, a very quick four-question survey will appear. So go ahead and fill it out for us. The words very quick are literally on your screen. It'll take you a few seconds to just give us some feedback, and we really do appreciate it. Also, once again, sign up for more sessions. There are a lot of other college presentations happening this evening, so go ahead and check them out so you can learn a little bit more about some other institutions out there. And last but not least, if you want to relive the fun, a recording will be available within the next few business days on the link on your screen at strivescan.com/Pennsylvania. Once again, you all, thank you so, so much, and I hope you have a great night. Bye, everybody.